Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you everything you need to know about page numbers, how to insert them, how to change them, how to start them on page 2, how to start them on page 3, and how to fully customise the look of them. So I've got a document up here, and I just zoom out and show you I've got 6 pages. So we're just going to start with 3 pages on show. And to insert a page number, all we need to do is access our headers and footers. There's 2 ways to do that. You can either go to the bottom of your page, double click, and as you can see, we're now in the headers and footers. To come out, double click in the main part of your document and you'll come out. Or you can go up to insert, go to footer, click on the drop down and go down to edit footer. And again, we're in the headers and footers. Once you're in there, you'll see there's a tab at the top here, headers and footers, go to there, go to page numbers, click on the drop down and select page numbers. Now, there's a very simple customization menu here. You can simply choose if you want to put your page numbers to the left, center, right, or inside and outside just simply refers to, as you can see here, page numbers are on the inside spine and again outside. And that's if you want to format a book or a leaflet. Further customization, if you go to format, you can customize your numbers. They can be letters or Roman numerals. You can also include your chapter number with your heading, and then you can use a different separator by using this menu here. I just click on there, click on the drop down, and you can see the different separators you can use. And then here you can either use continue from previous section, and that's if we divide the document up, and then also it allows you to start your page numbers from a different number. Here I've started it from 1 and just click OK. And as you can see, all of my page numbers are in the center of my footer. Now, to change your page numbers, go to page number. You can either go to page number and then format, which will bring up this page number format, or you can go straight to page number and format page numbers, and it will bring up this menu again. To delete your page numbers, simply click on page numbers and click remove page numbers. And you can see now they've all disappeared. Now, many people will have a cover page here and will want to start their numbers on page 2. To do that, go to page numbers, go to page number, and then uncheck this show number on first page, click, and as you can see, our page numbers are now starting on page 2. Now, for some people, you actually want the page number to start with number 1 on page 2 rather than number 2. So go to page numbers, go to format page numbers, and instead of starting from 1, let's change this to starting from 0 and click OK. 0 being the cover page, and now we can start from number 1. Some people will also want to start their page numbers from page 3 or page 4, 5, 6, depending on how many pre-pages you have. So you might have a cover page and an index page and an acknowledgement page, so you don't actually want the numbers to start on page 2. So there is a way to do it, it's a little complicated, stay with me, and I will show you how to start your page numbers on any page. So let's just go and delete those page numbers. Go back into your document, double click into the main area, and what I'm going to do is to start my page numbers on page 3 as a demonstration. So because I want them to start on page 3, I'm going to go to the bottom of page 2 and put my cursor at the very bottom. I'm going to go to layout. I'm going to go to breaks, click on the drop down, go down to section breaks and click the next page. So we're going to insert a section break. Now you'll see nothing really happens, but if you go to the home tab, go along to this icon here, which is show formatting marks. You'll see at the bottom of page 2, we've got a section break, and that's basically dividing your document into 2 different sections. So I've got section 1, which is the first 2 pages, section 2, which is the remainder of your document. So if we now go back into the headers and footers, double click at the bottom, you can see on the first 2 pages, we've got section 1, section 1, and then on page 3, we've got section 2. And we've also got this here, which says same as previous. So what we want to do, because this says same as previous, we actually want to unlink these 2 sections because currently they're linked because it says same as previous. So go to headers and footers, go to link to previous and click it. So you can see that same as previous has gone. If I click this again, click yes, you see same as previous comes back, and also this is grayed out to the top here. So we're going to uncheck that. So we've now unlinked these two sections. So now if I make sure my cursor is in section 2, go up to page numbers, click page numbers. I'm going to put them in the center. I want them to show on the first page of my section. Go to format. I want them to start at number 1 and then click OK. Then click OK again. And as you can see, my page number starts from number 1 on page 3, number 2, number 3, and number 4. So it's really important that you unlink those two sections, otherwise you'll get additional page numbers on here. Now, for if any reason some page numbers appear on these sections, just put your cursor into the first section, the headers and footers, just go to page numbers and just click remove page numbers, and anything there will be removed. Now I'm going to zoom in because I want to show you how to change your page numbers in terms of customization. So sometimes this is a bit fiddly. So double click on your page number. Now you'll see there is a slightly blue hue to this rectangle. You actually want that to be grey in order to format your page numbers. So double click again and keep double clicking until it turns grey, but ensure there is no flashing cursor. If there's a flashing cursor, you'll have to come out again, go back in and double click again, and just until it turns grey. Once it turns grey, then you can use the whole of this section up here in the Home tab to customize your page number, just in the same way you would with any other font. So you can change the font here. Let's change it to this one. You can increase the size of it. Use the increase font size tool. You can make it bold. You can change the color here if you want to. Change it to red. Change it back to black if you want to. You can underline it. You can move it to italics. And that's the way you can fully customize your page numbers. If I just zoom out, and you can see how I've altered the look of those page numbers. Now, just one small tip. If you've put a section break in, let's just go back to those formatting marks. Let's go to this page here. If for any reason you've put that section break in and you actually want to move those numbers again because you found you've added an additional page at the beginning, and unless you know how, sometimes it can be a bit of a challenge to delete these section breaks because you can't just, I'm clicking and dragging and I can't. And if I click at this end, I can't click at that end. If I try to delete them this way, you can see I can't delete that section break. What you actually need to do is to hold down your Command or Control key, click on it, you can see it's highlighted, then press the delete key. And as you can see, then it's deleted. Once it's deleted, you can go back and fully customize your page numbering again, as we did before, using all the section breaks and the links to the previous sections. So I'm just going to remove the section break now because I want my page numbers to page 1 for my thumbnail. And I've just deleted that section break and we've started from page 1. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.